some of the best people that I know in my life, the people I can depend most on, are people that I've met through the game of football. It's a tough world. You've got to take a blue-collar approach to things. And so that was our thing when we came here. We said, we didn't really care how big a house you live in, what kind of car you drive. We're going to play tough physical football, and it's, we're going to build it. It's going to take time.
Set the tone here.
All right.
He's been in a ton of stuff. He's a big Texas football fan. All right, I heard a quick 2-minute clip this morning where somebody asked him, what drives him to be the best? And he said, he goes, I would be embarrassed. This is his answer. I would be embarrassed if I did not give everything I had every day to my craft.
This is the Buckeye drill.
Person with the ball picks it up on the whistle and tries to basically run through the other guy, and the other guy has to make a tackle and stop it.
And it's just an exciting, energetic drill. Here we got speed stations.
So this is just the ball security drills.
Making sure you have a tight grip on the ball and you're running through contact, and that's something that's important for games. Stay low and hit the hole, that's something they really emphasize.
The O-line working the CDs. Driving under the chute, staying low. More ball security.
Coach Siebel just drills them into our brain. Do it, do it, do it, and you never forget it. I mean, I can still tell you right now what I do every single day.
You ask about highlights. Obviously, plenty from the Pensbury game.
Play like a 0-0. We have a full season to go, and I'm still excited.
The South game, just we preach special forces, and Will Silverman running down and recovering that fumble. Great hustle by a guy. Here's a starting wide receiver, and he's running down on kickoff. Watching our kickers develop, who are both going to be back next year. One's going to be a sophomore, one's going to be a senior. Watching those guys work really hard all year and develop, that was a great memory. And Coach Barno working with them. In the Pennridge game, just looking at Pat Keller at halftime, and he had been hit hard a lot of times, but he went out and kept fighting as a 15-year-old sophomore. The North Penn game.
Right there at our house today. They gotta understand who they're playing. You guys gotta come out 100% effort on every play. Take care of each other. If you're not playing for yourself, play for your brother. Play for your school. Play for pride.
Yes, sir.
1, 2, 3.
Go.
Watching Ethan Shine run downhill like a young man, like a big young man, and watching us surge against him was really great. The West game, you know, that first half, just like the first half against Pensbury, was a fond memory. And then the Conwell game. Making a lot of plays and not, you know, even getting our first onside kick and then going down and scoring right before the at the end of the game, not quitting and keep fighting. For me, Connor is the Iron Patriot. That's the highlight out of all of them, is him running out onto that field against Pensbury basically a year after he was diagnosed and for him to hold against North Penn. So those are some of the memories that stick out to me on the game field.
East football. We play this game hard nosed. Blue collars. We take names and we leave with a W. It doesn't matter.
Yes, sir.
Who's on the other side?
Let's go.
With one thing in mind tonight, and that's a damn W.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. 48 minutes. Blue collar football. East side on 3-1-3.
Let's go.
We'll be right back.
looking? And are we smiling?
Yeah, where are we looking?
Are we smiling?
We're looking at Liam.
Look at both cameras.
Smiling.
What you talking about?
Stop making me smile, Griffin.
Box gonna get
good lighting. Sneezing.